So how did you go from skin diving to turtle conservation?
Well, you can continue to be a scuba diver much longer than you can continue to be a freediver. Because you get a little old and tired of the sea, you know, and you're not as strong when you're 50 as when you're 15. So when it comes a time when I had, you know, people have to do that at a certain age. It helps anybody, you know. So I decided, before I stopped diving, I needed a bigger boat. And I made sure while I was diving and making some money to build that bigger boat. So when I stopped diving in a small boat, I had a bigger boat to do better fishing in. See, you could go fishing in this boat and do lines and nets.
And so you came upon saving this breed of turtle.
I did not plan this thing. I mean, a lot of people see me do this, I'm around the world on TV and so forth. And they thought this was a plan of mine. It was not a plan. I was a person to see turtles from the deep, lay eggs, lay babies, have them go back into the sea and so forth. But I was camping here in a tent. My family, of course, every weekend. My home is in Portland. And so one night I happened to be here alone in my tent. And this big female turtle came up to my tent, right next to my door, dug her hole, threw sand in on me while I was sleeping, laid her eggs and left. So when I got next morning that I saw that, I searched for the eggs and the eggs were right behind my door. You know, I hid it because people are still in the habit of eating, some people, not all, eating turtles. So I wanted to make sure that those turtle eggs would hatch and the babies would go back into the sea, some would live. But it didn't happen like that. 2 months after, I was there, standing with 2 visiting friends, and these babies hatched out around my feet. I didn't plan for it. I didn't know that they were still there. I thought they had gone. So in my anxiety, I collected a small bucket full of babies and put in a small basin of water. And that's how I started. It was not a plan of mine. I had to teach myself how to deal with these baby turtles. I know normally baby turtles eat jellyfish in the ocean. I did not know what they would eat otherwise, because I cannot get jellyfish. And so I coaxed them and fed them, they would not eat. And I made a deal with them. If you don't eat within 6 days, I'll put you back in the sea. On the 6th morning, my wife made some tuna fish sandwich. And I was eating a tuna fish sandwich, leaning over, speaking to my turtle, and a piece of the tuna fell into the water. They rushed and ate it up. And then I said, I would go in town and buy some tuna fish. And I've been eating tuna fish for the past 17 years.
Oh, darn.
Just coincidence.
Well, I know having, you know, attended a few turtle sanctuaries like in Costa Rica and other parts of the world, that the baby turtles have only a 10% mortality, or, you know, they only 10% of babies that are born to a hatch actually survive in the wild.
Much less than that. Much, much less than that. These little things, especially hawksbills, they are small. They're smaller than the other turtles. And they're little and soft and float and slow. And everything eats them out. They begin to be eaten by crabs on the beach.
Yeah.
Then they're eaten by eels and octopus around this rocky coastline. And as they go out in the ocean, they're eaten by the frigate birds and fish. So it is said that around maybe 1 of 3,000 of these will survive. 1 from 3,000.
So how long, you know, you have three different tanks here and then smaller tanks.
Yeah.
And in this tank to our my right, there is a tank of probably close to 100, if not over. Like 300? Holy cow. 300. Itty bitty babies, and they're less than, you know, they fit on a palm. They're smaller than the palm of my hand. Do you have compound, and then you have the typical right behind, which is, you know, comprised of certainly much larger turtles, and then, you know, a few well, call them teenagers,
yeah,
to their right. How long do you keep these turtles until you release them back into the wild?
I got to realize that toad being solitary fight when you have them together. And from small they fight. They kill each other. So you have to have sizes by themselves.
Okay.
You really can't mix those two sizes there. Those teenagers you're talking about,
mm-hmm,
which is about a year, 14 months or so, you can't put them among baby toads. Now toads don't eat toads. But the bigger ones would kill those by holding on to them to play with them and squeeze them. And hold them down on the water too long and drown them.
Okay.
You see, so you have to have sizes by themselves.
Mm-hmm. And so how long will you say, like, these guys behind us, which are, I'll call young adults, when will they go back into the wild?
Well, these are more like 2.5 and 3 years old, except for 3 bigger ones. And I keep them between 4 or 5 years. Because by 4 or 5 years, they are strong. They can dive to feed themselves.
Mm-hmm.
They are fast. They can get away from humans and sharks. And they will survive better than if you put like a 1 year old.
Okay.